drama film called Toi Tu Tian. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. Jack Chen Yuxi is a 20-year-old melancholic college student from Taipei. His grandfather moved to Taiwan from Anxi in Guangzhou, China, in the mid-19th century. At the tender age of 5, Jack lost his mother. She suffered from chronic depression and one day overdosed on her pills. With no mother and his father always busy with work, Jack feels lost and has no idea about his future. Jack has an eccentric history teacher who everyone dearly calls Professor P. Sometimes, the history teacher is also called the Professor Pig. Jack and his friends often go to his office for private classes. One day, in one such private class, Jack notices an ancient camera in the professor's room and uses it to click the picture of a wall clock. However, he suddenly remembers something important and hands the camera back to the professor, abruptly leaving the class with his friends. The professor is left puzzled by their sudden departure, but he gets even more astonished when he notices that the wall clock stopped momentarily after Jack clicked its picture. Professor P wonders to himself, is he the one? It turns out that Jack was rushing to wish his girlfriend a happy birthday, but she breaks up with him instead. She tells him that he doesn't know what true love is after he gives her a teddy bear, forgetting that she is allergic to soft toys. The next day, Jack goes to the Toi Tu Tian Museum with his class, accompanied by Professor P. Toi Tu Tian was the most prosperous area in Taiwan during the Japanese occupation in the 1920s. The museum has a vast collection of relics from that time, such as the water dungeon, where Taiwan's founding father Dr. Chiang was imprisoned by the Japanese. Jack notices the phrase, "The flower of youth is," carved on the dungeon. By the water dungeon, a man gives Jack and his friends a commemorative coin with Dr. Chiang's portrait. Jack continues to wander around the museum and comes across the iconic South Street Festival painting of the TTT. Seeing Jack checking out the painting, Professor P hands him the same old camera and asks him to take its picture. Jack obliges, and lo and behold, time freezes again, and the painting comes to life. Just as Jack begins to wrap his head around it, he gets sucked into the painting and sent to 1922 Taiwan. There, he runs into his friend, Black Cat, and his younger brother, but they do not recognize him. The brothers drag Jack with them to participate in a cultural procession where he gets into trouble with a textile businessman named Mr. Lin. However, a woman named Miss Ginger, who looks just like Jack's mother, saves him. Ginger also owns a clothing business and is an arch rival of Mr. Lin. Jack is stunned to see his mother, but she too doesn't recognize him. Puzzled and overwhelmed, Jack passes out from shock and wakes up the next day in Miss Ginger's home. He ventures out into the street with Black Cat and his friends to try and understand what's going on. At the market, he and his new mates are threatened by the businessman's son, Wen Xiao. Later, Jack learns that a man named Master Pig, who looks just like Professor P, works as a tailor for Miss Ginger. Angry at Professor P for sending him inside the painting, Jack gets into a quarrel with Master Pig, who denies knowing him. The commotion attracts the attention of the Japanese colonial police. Miss Ginger again comes to their rescue and takes the Japanese officers away. Master Pig then finally comes clean about his identity and role in bringing Jack here. The professor takes Jack to his theater and promises to tell him the reason he brought him here when the right time comes. It turns out Master Pig is Professor P after all, and he not only works as a tailor, but as a play director as well. Jack notices a beautiful girl named Rose in the audience and instantly falls for her. Rose and her friends are geisha, i.e., girls that are trained to entertain men with conversation, dance, and song. To impress Rose, Jack takes on the role of a tree, and the play begins. He turns the romantic tragedy into a comedy, just to make her laugh, making spectators laugh till their stomachs hurt. The play is suddenly interrupted when Japanese officers come barging in. The Japanese officer reveals that the Crown Prince of Japan will be visiting Taiwan in the coming week, and hence, all non-Japanese entertainment will be banned until after his visit. However, the professor and others resist the Japanese hegemony. Rose stands up and starts singing a Taiwanese song in defiance of the Japanese occupation, soon followed by others. Unable to stop or control the entire crowd, the Japanese officers leave with their tails between their legs. Later, Jack finds a drawing of the present-day Taiwan and attempts to go back, but without success. The professor tells the dork that the picture is incomplete and hence can't function as a time portal. Moreover, one must make a wish with all their heart to teleport. It is also revealed that the professor came to the Tua Tiu Tian with a dream of becoming rich. Here, he met Ginger and fell in love. Ever since then, he has been going in and out of the TTT to earn a lot of money and win over Ginger's heart. Professor proposes a deal to Jack, asking his help to keep other suitors away from Ginger in return for getting the painting complete. Jack agrees to this obvious blackmail. The professor continues to court Ginger, but without success. Meanwhile, Jack becomes close with the professor's theater actors. He helps them create melodies and new looks for their play with his knowledge of the 21st century. One day, Rose comes to a neighboring store where multiple suitors, including Wen Xiao, are trying their luck with Rose. Jack also rushes there with his guitar and serenades her with the happy birthday song. Mesmerized by him, Rose formally introduces herself to him. Just as they get to know each other, they are suddenly interrupted by a speech being delivered by Dr. Chiang Wei-shui, Taiwanese doctor and freedom fighter, outside the store. In his electrifying speech, Dr. Chiang calls out Japanese occupation and the opium cultivation imposed on Taiwanese. The Japanese officers soon start to disperse the crowd, forcing Jack and Black Cat to hide in a shop. Mr. Lin coincidentally brings his son to the same shop and scolds him for listening to Dr. Chiang's speech, jeopardizing Mr. Lin's covert business relations with the Japanese. Mr. Lin reminds Wen Xiao that their fabric business is doing well because of Japanese support and investment. Jack and Black Cat overhear the whole conversation. Over the course of the next few days, Jack and his theater friends get busy preparing the geisha girls for the governor's party, where all local VIPs are to be invited. Jack tells Rose that he came from the future and about the end of Japanese occupation, while she tells him her wish to one day become a professional singer. Jack tells her that he'll introduce her to autotune and she'll be famous in no time. At the party, Dr. Chiang again clashes with the Japanese officials, but before things could escalate, Rose defuses the situation with her charming performance. Later, Jack steals Rose away and wanders around the governor's mansion. When a group of guards pass by, they hide in a water dungeon. At that moment, Jack tells Rose that in the future, everything becomes so easy that people get lost and forget about their youth and dreams. Inspired by Jack's words, Rose carves "The Flower of Youth Is" on the dungeon before kissing him. Jack finally realizes what true love is. Or maybe he's just happy to see her. While returning home, Jack notices Ginger sneaking out of the house at night to go to an opium club. When he reaches the club, Jack finds Ginger stoned out of her mind, with Professor P by her side. Reminded of his late drug addict mother, Jack scolds the professor for enabling Ginger and takes her home. After coming to her senses, Ginger reveals that she lost her husband and son to cholera 10 years ago. She uses the high to momentarily escape the unbearable pain of losing her child. Jack figures out that the professor needs money to help Ginger buy opium and relieve her pain. Ginger admits that she likes the professor, but can't commit to him because he keeps disappearing as if he doesn't belong in this world. It is then revealed that the Japanese colonial propaganda had Taiwanese people convinced that an addict quitting opium could lead to their death. Jack vows to help Ginger and the other Taiwanese who have become victims of opium and begins a fierce awareness campaign with the help of Dr. Chiang. Jack also makes the professor burn down the local opium house. However, this puts Dr. Chiang and Professor P on the Japanese hit list. The Japanese officers arrive at Ginger's home to arrest the professor. However, Mr. Lin interferes, and for the first time, he speaks out against the Japanese occupation. Absolute chaos ensues. The Japanese officer accidentally fires his gun, fatally wounding Ginger. The Japanese officer orders all hospitals to not admit patients with gunshot wounds before heading to arrest Dr. Chiang. Left with no choice, Jack takes Ginger back to the theater, deciding to take her to the future for treatment. After everyone leaves, Wen Xiao notices that the bullet also hit his father. Dr. Chiang arrives, but by then it is too late, and Mr. Lin dies in his son's arms. At the theater, Jack asks the professor to take Ginger to the future while he decides to stay. Jack has finally realized his purpose in life. Chiang is arrested for treason, while the working-class Taiwanese are barred from appearing in public during His Majesty Prince Hirohito's impending visit. Wen Xiao and his friends join forces with Jack's group and plot to free Dr. Chiang. One night, the geisha girls distract the guards, and Jack and the boys free Dr. Chiang from the infamous water dungeon. Meanwhile, the local Taiwanese opium trader, whose business is being threatened by Dr. Chiang's anti-opium campaign, hires Korean assassins to assassinate the Japanese prince to frame the doctor. Dr. Chiang catches wind of the plot and vows to protect the prince. Jack and his friends spread rumors around town that those who don't attend Prince Hirohito's arrival ceremony will get cursed, hoping to attract a large crowd to make things difficult for the assassins. I guess Jack has never played Assassin's Creed. Big crowds make it easier. By the time Prince Hirohito arrives, Professor P also returns from the future. As the prince heads towards Ginger's shop, Jack and Professor P notice the assassins on the roof, gearing to shoot the prince. While the professor hurls the painting towards the bullet, Jack and Rose throw themselves at the bullet, hoping to stop it. However, before anyone has to die, the professor clicks a picture of Jack, Rose, and the bullet with the painting, teleporting all of them to present-day Taiwan. Meanwhile, in 1923 Taiwan, Dr. Chiang and other Taiwanese chant slogans of freedom and equality in front of Prince Hirohito's procession. Dr. Chiang becomes the first Taiwanese to be arrested for petitioning for freedom, and the colonial government begins hunting down anyone involved. Professor P returns to present-day Taiwan. As he proceeds to send Rose and Jack back to the past, Jack turns to Rose and tells her his decision to stay. He tells her that he wanted to go with her, but he likes the way he was before. Brave and reckless. Also, there's no internet in the past. Moreover, the 1920s are her golden days, not his. He wants to stay back to create his own golden days. He wants to tell his people about their history. Jack then kisses Rose, like a boss, before tearfully parting ways. Ginger arrives, and Jack embraces her with tears of joy. To Professor P's joy, Ginger then reveals her decision to stay with him in the present. Jack wanders inside the TTT Museum by himself and looks at the writings on the water dungeon that now says, "The flower of youth is the blooming rose," while holding his tears back. Jack has completed Rose's sentence when he was with her in the past. All the blissful time he spent with Rose flashes before his eyes, and Jack eventually breaks into tears. Later, Jack goes to meet his friends and embraces them like never before. After all, he knows what true love is now. They sit by the water and talk about their aspirations. The movie then ends with Jack noticing and smiling at a girl who looks just like a blooming rose. Subscribe for more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out. Thanks for watching.